Merry Christmas, happy holidays, everyone. When this video comes out, Christmas Eve will be the next day, and then Christmas, and we can all celebrate. While I've had this sitting around, I didn't add this into any preview videos because I wanted it to be a complete surprise when I started working on it. Now, I am going to be building a cool little diorama I picked up online. It's no longer, that company is no longer available. I went to their website, you can't see anything, and I just bought this like a month or two ago. So I'm not gonna get into companies or anything. They didn't sponsor this video. They didn't send the product. I went and picked it up myself, and I'm going to get to building it. It is the Grinch, as you can tell by the thumbnail. This kit comes with a 3D printed base of the living room with the fireplace, a block wall, block background to the fire pit. We got a nice mantle. You can see this is 3D printed. There's some filament left over. Some strings will cut free before we get some primer on it. It's got a fake wood floor. It's got some indents for the figure, and it is beautifully sculpted. It's even sculpted in the back, but I'll be using the back to attach some stuff, so we'll only be looking at this diorama from the front from now on. It is a great size. You can see based on the building board, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 inches across. It is 5 inches from front to back, and it is about 7 inches tall, so it's a beautiful size. All of this, of course, the Grinch is fictional. Resin cast Grinch body. Look at the sharp detail on that. That is as it comes. Cast out with the big belt on him, his Santa outfit, his bulbous bottom end. Nice details there. We've got the beautiful Grinch face. I love that the pupils are highlighted. We can paint these eyes quite easily. This is a cartoon, so you decide how you want to paint it up and detail it. Lovely design on that. Excellent resolution from however they get that cast. There is a fireplace included in this kit. To go back here, there is a fire for the fireplace. Nice details. You can paint that up and design it. I've got a different idea. He's got two arms, of course, with hands molded in one piece. Somehow this arrives through the Postal Service without getting smashed or broken. They packed it very, very well. Just needs some minor cleanup on those parts, as you'll have to do with any cast or printed pieces. Beautifully done. Key marks to locate into the body. You will need to use super glue to attach these parts. Being resin or 3D printed, they will not respond well, if at all, to styrene model glue. It will not melt the plastic. These are his legs we're looking at. Little stubby little legs. And his feet in his little slippers. Those are all printed out or cast out. Excellent, and those have the key marks for it that will interlock into the base so that you can glue him securely in place. If you don't like that, shave those off with your knife and relocate them to a different place. So we've got the figure here. That's all that's in the kit. And then I went shopping for accessory parts because it's a little diorama and I didn't want to do it just as it is with just paint and decoration. First up, I needed a suitable size Christmas tree. Over in the Christmas decorations at Hobby Lobby, I found this. Everything's like 50, 60% off all the time in the Christmas area. The tree's a little big for my needs. This The spool here won't be used at all. I'll be pulling it free. This is a wire base on there. I will be cutting this off to a height that I like instead and decorating it in a manner I see fit since it's my model. I got some ribbons for the mantle and maybe the tree as a little garland or a mantle cloth to hang over the mantle in that holiday theme. That's just Christmassy ribbons. You get all this stuff at craft stores. I'm not going to go through every place I got it. Found online in the dollhouse furniture, a beautiful log with fire, way better than I thought. The one that came with the model has a little 9-volt orange LED. We're going to be able to put that in the fire. I made sure that it fits, and boy, does it ever fit perfectly. Check that out. That couldn't be, it looks like it was designed for it. So we're all set on that. I've got some orange kitties because I have an orange kitty with white markings, so we're going to put one of those in the diorama somewhere. I went over to the dollhouse department and found all of these at Hobby Lobby, a little choo-choo train for around the tree or at least near the tree. We got some rugs over that cold wood flooring. We'll decide which one of those we want to use. I got some beads. I didn't know if I'd use these or not, but I thought, well, they might make for cool little ball ornaments, sticking them back on the areas of the tree. We'll see. If not, they don't cost anything with your coupon. Got a beautiful little lamp here. That's going to go on top of the mantle place, that beautiful lamp. And my fireplace would have books. Now, I'm not going to use the shelf they come on. I'll just be using the assortment of books, some of them on there, to put on that mantelpiece, but that's how I want to do it. And finally, all the stuff I got with the kit off eBay, I picked up some very small multicolored lights. I've got blues, reds, greens, and yellows in there, pinks. That I'm going to string around the actual tree. We'll run that all the way around the tree. And then I've got another set of lights from the dollar store. These large stars. I think, if they don't look too bad, I think I'd like to frame the base in them. All the way around the outside to add a little light to it. Just a decoration to bring emphasis to the diorama. And then I've got a 9-volt battery holder. I used to do electronics projects all the time. To hold the 9-volt just to run the fireplace itself. All of those battery packs will just be attached to the back of the outfit. Now they all run on different voltages. This runs on 3 volts, 2 AA's. This runs on 1.5 volts. And this runs on anywhere from 9 to 12 volts. You could, of course, install resistors and step downs and all this stuff and have them wired to one thing. I don't mess with any of that. I want quick and easy. So I'm just going to be attaching all that stuff to the back of the diorama and using it all that way. It's not like you're going to be straining yourself to flip 3 switches or anything. So I don't need it that precise. I just want it to look cool. I'm going to get to work. All I've got to do is glue the figure together. Glue all these parts together and check for fit. I'm going to use gel super glue and thin super glue if I need to fill any major gaps. Otherwise, we're just going to put it together. I'm going to cut off the little extra filaments on the 3D printed base, and then I'm going to be ready for primer. So we'll be back real quick. Figure kits usually don't take a lot to assemble, and this one certainly didn't. So I set up a lot of the stuff for the diorama forthcoming, and you can see what it's kind of look like when we're going to get stuff painted. And I haven't attached any lights or anything yet, but we're going to get a great idea then of scale. I didn't want to make the tree too big, and this was the exact perfect size tree. Took a set of wire cutters, snipped it off that spool, drilled a hole in the base so that it sits in there, and then I will epoxy it in completely when we're all done, when I get the lights wrapped around it and the wire hidden around the backside and everything like that. The Grinch is all assembled. I used thick CA gel super glue. I fill each hole where we saw the parts pushed together, squished them in, and then used a Q-tip to dab it around and fill any gaps that I needed and any other things like that I'm not too worried about. So he looks awesome. Check him out. Now the head fits tightly over that, so that did not have to be glued. I couldn't be able to pull that off and maybe paint it and stuff like that. We don't know. But he is beautiful. He's very disapproving, just like looking at it. He's like, geez. So he looks awesome. Excellent sculpt. You see, I marked the arms when I started to fit them, so I knew which side fit. We got the legs down there, a little bit of gap filling CA, that thick CA glue, and some activator. Same with the legs, got it all taken care of. And he interlocks nice and tightly with that base, which means when we get some paint on it, I'm only going to need a little bit of dab of super glue to hold him in place forever. And he looks awesome. He's also balanced well enough that he'll stand on his own and judge us over there, but he's a great looking dude. That is a really nice figure, and it's a beautiful size, you can see, compared to my hand. Not too big, not too small. We got the base set up here. This is what I want to go with. I've got the fireplace. I just need to drill a very small hole halfway up through the back of the fireplace when I'm done painting to run the wires through. We got the little rug, we got the little cat. My cat's named Linus, and he looks somewhat like that, so he's got to be in there. We got the little choo-choo train around the base of the Christmas tree. We got the ribbon. I'm going to need to just take an iron and fold it down so that it hangs on each side, but we'll have that Christmas-style mantle, you know, cloth over the top so it looks nice. We got the little Tiffany lamp, and we got some books on the mantle like everyone should have. So I'm going to get to working on stuff. All I've got to do is get some primer, black primer on the base, gray primer on the Grinch. We don't need to film that. So we'll jump right into hand painting and detailing. Is this an absolute blast or what? I'm so glad that I came across that kit out there and have a chance to build it up. It's just awesome. Check him out. He is all ready to go. He is glorious. And it was all craft paints and dollar store stuff, except for the Army Painter washes that I used around the edges. I still haven't been able to create my own wash that is as thin as theirs and color tinted, that just kind of goes around and does exactly what you need it to. I can make big basic washes like I did on the base there. Those are fine, but making a real intricate one, those Army Painter ones are absolute number one in my book. You can find those as an assortment, and they're really, and they last forever. Those little dropper bottles, they 3-4 drops does most of a figure. Look at that face with the shiny eyes. The pupils were already set into the mold, so he's kind of looking, you know, discerning at you. For the mouth, the eyebrows, and the nose, I used a black marker. They're actually called Molotov Black Liners by the Chrome People. You can get these at Model Roundup. They're in all different sizes, and I have a big assortment of them. They work very well for that, so he looks awesome. I just got to glue the head on the body, and that is all set to go. Beautiful molding and just craft paints and some Army Painter washes. We're all set. This is all the rest of the stuff I got to do. Check out that base. Did a little wash around there. Blacked out the firebox. Got it dirty and soot. Made that soot across the top. Could have gone a little more on the mantle, but they clean it every season. Used some pearlescent paint and gold paint on the crest on the mantle. Did the wood staining with the variations. Got that red granite. I live in Wisconsin. Red granite's extremely popular for chimneys and foundations and all that, and that's what I wanted to replicate, was the look of my area. I got my little stack of books here glued together. We got the beautiful kitty. My cat's named Linus, and he looks almost just like that. That's why I had to get that. That's going to go on the base. We got our little Tiffany lamp, our choo-choo train. We got our ribbon here. I've got to get upstairs with the iron and flatten that down so that it sits nicely on the mantelpiece, like they would drape it with the light and the little bookies. So we'll see if I can get that bent down. Got the fireplace all set to go inside. All I have to do is take that bulb. It's not an LED in this one. It's a grain of wheat bulb. I got my 9-volt power base. I got my cheap dollar store 9-volt battery. I just got to solder these ends together and get it to go. I've got the tree cut off the base. And all set, and I wrapped those lights around it already. Isn't that pretty? Jingle bell, jingle bell. So, we are all set to go. I'm just going to start pressing everything together. A little drops of thick gel super glue will hold everything in place. The gel works better than the super liquid because it won't run into everything when you're placing final items. And I like to glue it all down to make sure that it doesn't run around or anything. So, I'm going to get all that ready, and we'll just come back for that final reveal. Merry Christmas, everyone. I got this video scheduled to come out the Wednesday, day before Christmas Eve and Christmas. And here we are. I got this done in 2 whole days. We got it all lit up. We got the fire glowing in the fireplace. We got the tree lit up with those awesome string lights. And we are all set. I got the beads in there. We got Mr. Kitty by the glow of the Christmas tree. Wait until the kids go to bed to bat that train. We got the awesome Grinch lit up by the light of the fire and the Christmas tree. We got the books and everything, and it is just a stunner. Beautiful. Love how that tree lights up the whole thing, gives those shadows off. Let's just see everything so nicely. Let me get the lights on so we can see the rest of the model with a full set of lights on the display in the shop. Isn't that just a peach? Now, of course, we got that beautiful fire, which is taller in the kit than it is in the model that I have, but that's fine. You could always build that or use that for something else. That makes a nice fire once primed and painted. Or I went my route, found the dollhouse fire pit, which fits in that fireplace beautifully. We got the tree cut from other holiday parts. We got some dollhouse stuff in here. Mr. Linus, he's not scared of the Grinch. Linus loves everybody. And we got the beautiful work. Now we'll go all the way to the back You can see we got our 9-volt box and we got our 1.5-volt box for the lights. You can see the wire going to the lights in the back, and I didn't try to hide it whatsoever. Why? Because you could see the light in the back of your Christmas tree too. You could see the wire, so it's supposed to be there. Your tree isn't, you know, lit up by magic. So that is just fine, and that just sticks to the back. I don't care if you wanted to enclose that and rewire things and install it, go ahead. But this right here is how I display my models, and you can't see a darn thing anywhere around either side till you get way around the back. When you look at it from the front, you can see you've got a beautiful model, and even with all the lights on in the shop, I carry so much light, we can still see the fire and definitely the Christmas tree. An excellent display. I'm going to be putting this in a display box. You can get those cheap basketball display boxes at Hobby Lobby that'll keep the dust off your models forever. But what a fun kit to build. Very easy, of course. Figure kits are always easy to assemble. It's the painting that makes the difference, and I like mine. I did all the detailing on it. I really enjoy this. Hopefully they will come out with more fun kits like this, and I will be able to pick stuff up, because there are not a lot of Christmas kits out there. There just aren't. You would think there'd be Christmas-themed vehicles and everything, but not really. I look and look, and this year I was lucky for a Christmas build to find a Christmas theme. As always, thanks for watching the workshop. Build your models for you. Have a good time doing it. Don't worry about anyone else. And when you just relax and have a nice time, you can get yourself with a cool themed figure model just like this. Happy Christmas, Merry Hanukkah, Jerry New Year, and Happy Festivus. Merry Kwanzaa, Merry Christmas, Happy New Year to everyone. I'll see you at the next video.